Well, that's a great idea in theory. The problem is there are a lot of factors affecting how viruses are transmitted between people in society. Different cities are going to be different, not just in terms of weather, like you mentioned, but also in terms of the kind of non-pharmacological public health interventions. So it's a long word, but what I mean is in terms of the kind of border controls they have, in terms of whether they have closed their schools, in terms of whether people are practicing social distancing, whether cities are locked down, all of these things are going to have an effect on how COVID-19 spreads. So these are potentially confounding factors which would affect how much the virus is actually transmitted between people in various cities. So even if you just conveniently bracket cities according to their temperature or humidity, these other confounding factors are going to make a straightforward interpretation of that very difficult. But to address your basic question, does temperature and humidity have an effect on coronavirus transmission? Well, in the laboratory, yes, warmer temperatures or conditions of higher humidity are generally not so favorable for coronavirus survival. And this may have some implications in the real world. However, we must remember that we are basically primarily an indoor species, especially when you have more extremes of temperatures. People tend to stay indoors in climate-controlled environments where things are always relatively dry and temperatures tend to be in the mid-20s where we are most comfortable. So in these kind of settings, any coronavirus and COVID-19 would be expected to transmit quite easily.